بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In this video I will talk about the cartilage, and this is the first video in the second exam material of histology. The first lecture was about the stem cells and the cloning, and I will not make a video for it, just study it from the summary and from the slides. So let's begin by the cartilage and introduction to the cartilage tissue. It's a special type of semi-solid supporting connective tissue, so it's a special connective tissue. It developed from primitive mesenchymal cells into chondroblast. It consists like any other connective tissue from cells, fibers, and abundant amount of extracellular component. For example, proteoglycan, chondroton, keratin, hyaluronic acid. The most important information that you mustn't forget about the cartilage, it doesn't contain vessels or nerves. Okay, so it's avascular and there is no nerves. And the nutrition occurs by diffusion. It's surrounded by a layer of this dense connective tissue. It's called the perichondrium. Cartilage is rather rare in the adult humans, but it's very important during development. So it's in the first years, in the first few days of the baby life, يعني of the fetus, من حياة الجنين, the skeleton will be almost cartilage. After a while, after a few years, the cartilage will be replaced by bone. Okay, so the big idea, the big picture for the cartilage, it's like any other connective tissue, consists of cells and matrix. We have three types of cells: chondrogenic, chondroblast, chondrocyte. Matrix, it's divided into fibers and the ground substance. Okay, so let's begin talking about the cells, and then we will talk about the matrix. The chondrogenic cells, we have two informations that you need to remember. Chondrogenic cells, they are derived from mesenchymal cell. The second information, those cells can differentiate into both chondroblast and osteoprogenitor. يعني الكوندروجينيك شو بتعطينا؟ بتعطيني كوندروبلاست واوستيوبروجينيتور. تمام؟ The other informations here, they are just a description for the chondrogenic cell appearing using the electron microscope. يعني مجرد وصف للكوندروجينيك باستخدام الالكترون مايكروسكوب. هم اغلبهم بالكتاب, يعني they are from the book. And I don't think they are that important. Just know that it's derived from mesenchymal and can differentiate into chondroblast and osteoprogenitor. The chondroblast now, we have two important information. It's derived from two sources, a mesenchymal cell and a chondrogenic cell. Okay, mesenchymal cell and chondrogenic cell can give us chondroblast. يعني الكوندروبلاست من وين جاي؟ جاي من الميزنكايمال أو من الكوندروجينيك. Okay, لقدام شوي راح أوضح هاي الشغلة أكثر. Okay, the other informations here, it's just a description for the chondroblast. Okay, it's from the book, so I don't think it's that important. Chondroblast, the function of it, it secretes an extracellular matrix and fibers like collagen and elastin. And when it secretes the extracellular matrix, it will imprison itself, يعني راح تحبس حالها inside something called a lacunae. And the chondroblast, when it's inside a lacunae, we called it chondrocyte. Okay, so the chondrocyte, it's the chondroblast inside a lacunae. Now, chondroblast undergo 1 to 2 final, the chondrocyte can undergo 1 to 2 final divisions, and we find them in groups. Okay, like 2 to 4 cells, and we call them isogenous groups. Now, the function of the isogenous groups, or the function of chondrocyte, is to maintain the integrity of the tissue. So differentiate between the function of chondroblast and the function of chondrocyte. Function of chondroblast, to secrete the extracellular matrix. Okay, you remember the suffix blast, it's an active cell. While the chondrocyte, the suffix site, it's an inactive cell, it will not secrete the matrix. So the function of the chondrocyte, to maintain the function, to maintain the integrity of the tissue. Now the chondrocyte, most of the informations here are just a description for it. I think that it's important to know that we have a young chondrocyte. It's a pale staining cytoplasm with many mitochondria. So it's more active than the older chondrocyte. The older chondrocyte, which are relatively quiescent, يعني هادئ أو ساكن, it display a greatly reduced complement of organelles with an abundance of free ribosomes. Okay, so just know that the chondrocyte, we have a young, it's more active, and the older, it's less active. Now, the relationship between different type of cells. We said that the chondrogenic cell, it's derived from mesenchymal cell. And chondrogenic cell will give us, will differentiate into chondroblast and osteoprogenitor. Osteoprogenitor, it's the mother cell in the bone tissue. We'll talk about it in the next video. And the chondroblast, it's derived from mesenchymal and chondrogenic. So, simply, الكوندروجينيك من وين جاي؟ جاي من الميزنكايمال. شو بتعطينا؟ بتعطينا كوندروبلاست واوستيوبروجينيتر. الكوندروبلاست من وين جاي؟ من كوندروجينيك ومن ميزنكايمال. Don't forget this relationship between cells. It's very simple. ميزنكايمال give كوندروجينيك and كوندروبلاست. كوندروجينيك can give كوندروبلاست and osteoprogenitor. Okay? Now let's talk about the matrix. It's fibers and the ground substance. Fibers, for example, collagen type 1 or type 2 and elastic. And the difference of composition between the fibers and the extracellular matrix give us different type of cartilage. يعني اختلاف الانواع يعني من الفايبر والground substance هو اللي بيحدد نوع الكارتلج. The ground substance either be a keratin, chondroitin sulfate or hyaluronic acid. Let's talk now about the growth of cartilage. We have the growth of cartilage occur by two ways: interstitial from the inside or appositional growth from the outside. The interstitial growth, the chondroblast within the existing cartilage divide and form small group of cells, isogenous groups. We have talked about them in the previous slides, which produce matrix to become separated from each other by a thin portion of matrix. Interstitial growth occur mainly in immature cartilage, okay? While the appositional growth, the mesenchymal cells in the perichondrium or the chondrogenic cell will differentiate into chondroblast, and appositional growth occur also in mature cartilage. So, the interstitial growth is from inside by the chondroblast. The appositional growth is from outside by the mesenchymal or the chondrogenic. Okay, so this is the perichondrium here, and this is the cartilage cells, chondrocyte. So if the perichondrium here, the chondrogenic or the mesenchymal differentiate and give us the chondroblast, this is an appositional growth. Okay, نمو من الخارج. And the interstitial growth, if the chondroblast produce a matrix, it will be an interstitial growth. Okay? Let's now talk about the type of cartilage. We have three type of cartilage based on the fiber component. يعني to make things easier for you, always ask yourself what are the cells, what are the fibers, and what is the matrix. يعني دائما اسأل حالك في أي نسيج شو الخلايا, شو الفايبر, وشو الماتريكس. Let's begin by the hyaline cartilage. It's the most common type. It's found in trachea, larynx, cover articular surfaces of bones, and it's begin developing from about the fifth fetal week. The precursor cells become rounded and form densely packed cellular masses. Centers of chondrification consist of chondrocytes. This is the cells, okay? Chondrocytes and lacunae. And we have the matrix. It's clear. So chondrocytes are the cells. The matrix is clear. What is the fibers? We have collagen type 2 is the dominant form in collagen fibers of almost all type of cartilage except the fibrocartilage. Okay, so remember that the hyaline cartilage, we have the chondrocyte, they are the cells. The matrix is a clear matrix. The collagen, we have type 2. The matrix appear clear. Why? Because the collagen fibers are too fine to be resolved by light microscope, and for another reason, because they have about the same refractive index as the ground substance. We will see it in a picture in a few seconds, but just remember that the clear matrix is because collagen fibers are too fine to be resolved by the light microscope, and they have the same refractive index as the ground substance. Collagen account for 40% of the dry weight of the matrix. Fresh cartilage contain about 75% of water, which forms a gel with the component of the ground substance. Cartilage is nourished by diffusion because it's avascular. Okay, don't forget this. Chondrocyte has single nuclei, granular cytoplasm, basophilic كروماتين ليبيد دروبليتس. I think this is important to know that the chondrocyte it has a lipid droplet and the size of the lipid droplet correspond to the maturity of the chondrocyte. Okay, so remember we have a young chondrocyte and old chondrocyte. I think they are related to each other. Okay, so just remember this. Here is the hyaline cartilage. Notice that the matrix is clear. What we mean by clear, you can't see any kind of fibers. Okay, but there is collagen type 2 fibers. They are not appear because of the previous two reasons that we have mentioned. Okay, and here we have another picture. Here we have the matrix. Okay, and here is the isogenous group of cells. Here we have something called interterritorial matrix, and here we have territorial matrix. What is the difference between them? Simply, the territorial matrix, this one, is more close to the lacunae, and it's denser than the interterritorial matrix. يعني في عنا هاد كله matrix, okay? بس العلماء يعني حبوا يعطوا اسمين. الإشي الغامق أو الإشي الغامق والأقرب لللاكيوناي سموه territorial matrix. والإشي الفاتح والبعيد عن اللاكيوناي سموه interterritorial matrix. Okay? That's very simple. Let's talk about the elastic cartilage. It has an abundant elastic fiber from its name. Within its matrix, it occurs in the epiglottic cartilage, the corniculate and the cuneiform cartilage of the larynx, the cartilage of the external ear and the auditory tube. Correspond histologically to hyaline cartilage, يعني بشبه الهيلاين cartilage, but in addition we have elastic fibers. Okay, let's see a picture for it. So here the matrix, it's not clear. Why? Because we can't see the elastic fibers. Okay, that's the basic difference between elastic and hyaline. The fibrous cartilage is a form of connective tissue transitional between dense connective tissue and hyaline cartilage. Chondrocyte may lie single or in pair, but most often they form short rows between dense bundle of collagen. So the appearance of chondrocyte in the fibrous, they appear in rows. In contrast to other cartilage type, here we have collagen type 1, but in the elastic and in the hyaline cartilage, we said that we have collagen type 2, but here we have collagen type 1. It's typically found in relation to joints forming intra-articular and disc and menisci, and is the main component of the intravertebral disc. This is the location of it. It merges impermeability into the neighboring tissues, typically tendons or articular hyaline cartilage. There is no perichondrium here. Okay, here is the chondrocyte. They appear in rows. So simply, يعني I think it's very easy to differentiate between the three types of cartilage. So don't forget that the hyaline, we have a clear matrix. The elastic, we can see the elastic fibers. And the fibrous, we see the chondrocyte in rows. Okay, this is the basic differences between the three types. Here we have a clinical correlation. It's mentioned in the book, and also the doctor mentioned it. We have said that the intervertebral disc is the form of the fibrous cartilage. It's here, I think. And we have something called the nucleus pulposus and annulus fibrosus. Now, if there is compression, if there is a pressure here, okay, the nucleus pulposus will get out from its place, okay, and it will pressurize on the spinal nerves. يعني إذا صار في ضغط في هاي المنطقة راح يخرج من مكانه نيوكليس. يعني هو هذا مرض الديسك، اوكي، عبارة عن خروج نيوكليس بالبوزس من مكانه، وبصير في ضغط على الأعصاب تبعت السباينال كورد، فبصير في ألم شديد. اوكي، now we have a special type of cartilage. It's the articular cartilage. It's a special type of hyaline cartilage. Okay, special form of hyaline cartilage. It transforms the articulating ends of the bones into lubricated. Okay, so where we find the articular cartilage in the articulating ends. Okay, نجعنا الدنيا. It transforms the articulating end of the bone into lubricated. We improve slightly compressible surfaces which exhibit very little friction. It's not surrounded by a perichondrium. That's the difference between the articular cartilage and the hyaline cartilage. So it's a form of hyaline, but there is no perichondrium, simply. and the main source of nourishment is by the synovial fluid, which fills the joint cavity. So in the end of bones, we will have the articular cartilage. It's a special type of hyaline cartilage. It don't have any perichondrium, and the nourishment by synovial fluid. It's divided into zones depending on the arrangement of chondrocyte and collagenous fibers. Let's see those zones. We have the tangential layer. The chondrocytes are small, flattened, and parallel to the surface. The most superficial part is devoid of cells, and collagen fibers in the matrix of the tangential layer are very fine. They run parallel to the surface. So, in the tangential layer, everything is parallel to the surface. The chondrocyte and the collagen fibers. Okay? I think there is a picture for it here. This is the tangential layer. You can see the chondrocytes are parallel to the surface. يعني موازي للسطح. The other layer, it's the transitional layer. The chondrocytes are slightly larger, and they are round and occur both singly and in isogenous groups. Collagen fibers take an oblique course. Okay, يعني بالبداية collagen fibers they were parallel. Now they are oblique. يعني صار في ميلان. Course through the matrix of the transitional zone. The third zone, it's the radial layer. We have fairly large chondrocytes from radial columns. Example, the stack of cells are oriented perpendicular to the articulating surface. The course of collagen fibers follows the orientation of the chondrocyte columns. So in each zone, you need to know how the chondrocytes are placed and how the collagen fibers are placed. يعني كيف الكوندروسايت بيكونوا موجودين وكيف الكولاجين فايبر بيكونوا موجودين. The last area, it's the last zone, it's the calcified cartilage. It rests on the underlying cortex of the bone. The matrix of the calcified cartilage layer stains slightly darker than the matrix of the other layers. So just let's see them here. Here's the radial layer. They are perpendicular to the transitional layer. They are parallel. And the transitional layer, they are between the tangential layer and the radial layer. The last thing to talk about is the degradation and regeneration of cartilage. Simply, in a few words, the regeneration is poor except in children. Okay, so due to fairly poor access of nutrients to chondrocytes, they may atrophy in deep part of thick cartilage, and water content decrease, and small cavities arise in the matrix, which often lead to calcification of cartilage. So the chondrocyte will die. Chondrogenic activity of the perichondrium is limited to period of active growth in the childhood period. So in the childhood period, we have an active growth of cartilage, but in the adulthood, we don't have. Also, although chondrocytes are able to produce matrix components throughout life, their production cannot keep pace with the repair requirement. Okay, so they can produce matrix, but this production can't equal the requirements of repairing to hyaline or articular cartilage. If these cartilage are injured after the period of active growth in the adulthood, يعني, the defects are usually filled by connective tissue or fibrous cartilage. So the extracellular matrix of this repair tissue is only poorly integrated with the matrix of the damaged cartilage. So in few words, the regeneration of cartilage is poor except in the childhood period. To summarize everything that we have talked about, we have three types of cartilage: hyaline, elastic, fibrocartilage. The important character of the hyaline, we have type 2. It's basophilic. The cells are chondrocyte cells. We have perichondrium in the hyaline cartilage except in the articular surface. Okay? Don't forget this. The location, articular ends, the nose, the larynx, the trachea, the bronchi, the ventral end of ribs. The elastic, we have type 2 and we have elastic fibers. And also we have perichondrium. So the perichondrium is found in the elastic and in the hyaline, except the articular cartilage of hyaline. The location of elastic, pinea of air, walls of auditory canal, auditory tube, epiglottis, cuneiform cartilage of the larynx. The final type is the fibrocartilage. We have type 1 collagen, not type 2. We have acidophilic matrix, not basophilic. The chondrocytes arrange in parallel rows. OK, Okay, like we have seen in the previous figures, between bundles of collagen, always associated with dense regular collagenous connective tissue or hyaline cartilage. The perichondrium is absent. Okay, so the perichondrium is absent in the fibrocartilage and in the articular hyaline cartilage. The location in the intervertebral disc, articular disc, pubic symphysis, and insertion of some tendons. And I think this is all about the cartilage tissue.